Hey friends, so I really felt led to talk a little bit more about my health journey. You know, a lot of times when people come to my page or they have some of my content, they might think, oh wow, she's always been like this, or you know, this is where she's at, it comes easy for her, cooking all these healthy things is easy. And that could not be further from the truth. You know, I struggled for a long time and still struggle with some things, and it wasn't for, I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for that God inside of me and Him giving me that power to continue to press on and move on. And I know when it comes to consistency and self-discipline, it's about making that choice that's right in front of you. And so many of us look at these goals and we have, like, you know, inspiration boards of all these big things. We want this body, we want to have these abs, we want to have all these things, but we see it as some grandiose thing and some grandiose outcome that is miles and miles and miles down the road, not understanding that they're literally baby choices. Like, you have a choice to make in the next time you want to eat. You know, that's a choice to say, hey, I'm gonna continue what I'm doing, or I'm gonna make a choice to be healthy. I'm gonna make an investment in my health and my future, knowing that one day I'm gonna get old and I'm not always gonna look like this and have this youth. So I'm gonna make an investment now for my elderly self, for my senior citizen self, to make a better choice today. And so I know for me, it was a long time for me to let all these things sink in. You know, I probably have gone probably over 10 to 15 juice fasts since 2008 possibly, when I first really got, like, aware of, like, healthiness, and then really 2010 starting to activate in it and understanding and researching throughout the years and breaking food addictions and strongholds on my life. You know, I realized one year I was just addicted for food to the sensation, because it gave me comfort when I was feeling stressed. So every time I was stressed, I would run and get something to eat, whether it was healthier or not. And that simple action of relying on food to actually give me peace was a problem. You know, that's not the intended purpose of food. And so I like to think of it was for me an addiction, because I believe that we're addicted to anything that we use outside of its intended purpose. And so it took years of just getting more information, watching all the documentaries, you know, reading the books, seeking teachers, seeking gurus, seeking all these things to educate my mind to support the choices that I was trying to make in my life. And so I wanted to make this video so, one, you can know where to start. And where I would say start is, again, make the next healthy choice. But while you're making those choices, you're gonna have to feed your mind to support the choices that you're making, because there was wrong thought patterns and wrong systems that's gotten you to the point where maybe you aren't the healthiest, maybe you have some health challenges, maybe you're trying to lose weight and you're struggling. There were systems in place that led to the decisions and the outcome that you have today. And so you have to rewire your brain. And so what I love to do, especially when I'm juicing and detoxing, is really taking that time to, like, sit back and look and see, okay, what are some things I need to rework? And what are some things that I need to rewire? And then the second part of it that really is, like, the crux of all of it, my entire being, was really leaning on the Word of God and allowing God's Spirit to just fill my heart and convict me about things I wasn't supposed to be doing, or places I wasn't supposed to be, or people I shouldn't be hanging out with, and behaviors that I had adopted for so long that I needed to get rid of. And by having both of those just align and come together, it really helped me to overcome a lot of the strongholds I had in my life, and allowed me to be consistent, and allowed me to just have self-discipline. And it really has just made me into the person that I am today. And so I want to read to you from 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7 that says, "For God has not given us a spirit of fear and timidity, but of power, love, and self-discipline." And so that means that the God of the entire shebang the entire universe, our creator, the God Supreme, you know, he has placed in us a spirit of self-discipline. I mean, hallelujah for that, right? We don't have to have this self-discipline in our own might. We don't need it in our own might because God has given it to us as a spirit within. And so he's given that self-discipline to us. And so the minute we start to align with that promise, because it is a promise from God, the minute we align with that promise, we will see fruit and it will come into fruition because we were always designed to be that kind of person. The stuff that we've had for years, the battles, trying to overcome and all that, that's not us. This is us, the person in 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7, that is us. We are meant to be powerful, loving, self-disciplined creatures. It's not meant for us to just fall and have no foundation and struggle and, you know, kind of go through all of that, but we do because we're only human. And so I want to let you know that that Spirit of God is living within you, giving you the power to actually overcome the addictions when it comes to your health, when it comes to anything you're battling with, and it's allowing you to make those choices you need to make. And so I hope that this inspires you. I know it was a lot packed into a few minutes, but I thought I would share because it really has helped me to overcome the things I've gone through in my past, and I want you to know that you're not alone, and I've been there before. So if you like this video, share it with someone who you know might need it. And also make sure that you subscribe and this week grab your weekly plan. You know, I have some recipes for you. I have more of this devotional for you, some morning moves, which is awesome. Just a lot I want to share with you. So make sure that you grab that and I will see you next week.